my beloved countrymen. I'd like to talk about governance and the heartaches and, of course, the downside of just being president. It is not that I am not happy. What motivated me to run was simply my sense of patriotism, for the simple reason that at that time, the issues that were really critical to the country were never brought to the fore before the national arena. And I was thinking that if somebody won't do it, then Mindanao could probably be a fractured island, if not totally lost from the rest of the republic. That was one, and if you remember, nobody was really talking about it, about the issues, how serious it is, and how wasteful it is to the lives of so many Christians and Moro people. Mahirap po kasi parang nakalimutan, it was done about good governance. Thank you. Guapa, no? And about infrastructures. But the real meat of the matter for us was really our survival in Mindanao. You have to understand that in 1521, when Magellan landed in Leyte, Islam was already thriving as a religion for the whole island of Mindanao. And therefore, in their conquest and everywhere, the Spaniards, of course, comes with the territory, massacred there and massacred here. And maybe the Visayans and the guys from Luzon were not so imbued kasi medyo malayo eh. It was not a contiguous place like Mindanao. Easy to travel and easy to conquer. But along the years, the Spanish tried, and the most that they could do was to build that fourth pilar in Zamboanga. But more than that, they were not able to enter or traverse the entire yung tinainga, tawag yung bubitoka ng Mindanao. And it continued with the Americans, but more forcefully this time, because aside from the cannons, noon ang mga, well, the natives never had any gunpowder. So the first time they heard the cannons, of course, it really drove them crazy and supplicate in surrender. But not in Mindanao, because I said, Islam was already spreading fast into the islands. Kaya, hindi makukuha yung Mindanao because there was a post. May poste sila. And that is Islam. So they fought the Spaniards. They resisted the Americans. And until now, they are fighting us. It is the same mother load. Kung gamitin mo yung kay Trump, the mother load is really the hatred that was created. Because in a war, in a rebellion, in putting down sedition, you have to kill people. In Mindanao particularly, not really to offend any conquering. But there were lots of killing and massacres. And this has contributed to the old age problem of hatred. And so it is not really entirely correct to say when you have this picture depicting the bodies of the Moro people in one pit, all naked, and lumped together, men, women, and children. And they would say, oh, wala na yan, Duterte. And even the commentators in Manila, is it oh, wala na yan. That's 1 century ago. Why bring it up with this dead? It never died. And that is why, pati tayo, how many years after the Americans left, still the problem of territory and ang hindi nila medyo siguro alam, it is the strong sense of nationalism of their old empire, the ruling dynasty known sa Malaysian, the Malay race was the Sri Visayas. And Mindanao was part of the Sri Visayas Empire. Para silang na-conquer at separated from their motherland. That is the story. It is not as simple as a rebellion there, as the bandit here, as the drug lords, and they abound. All forms of lawlessness, even among officials. Na kayong mga Moro dito, if you're around, do not begrudge me. Because you're not the only one na Moro. My Lola was in Maranao. My grandfather, Chinese. So, wag kayong maghinakit kung sabihin ko na kung ano ang totoo sa harap ng ating kapwa Pilipino. There's only one thing there, that's it's lawlessness. And I have to, or I had to decide to call in the military for the simple reason that I am short of warm bodies, kulang yung PNP 130, and I take care of all the islands, 7,000 islands comprising the Philippines. I had to. Kulang eh. Even in the matter of just being there for punitive police action. Pero kung sabihin mo talaga, prangkahan ko kayo, that my burning desire would be really to be president, I'm telling you now, God is there. Allah. Hindi ho. And if Congress can craft a law of a federal structure within 2 years, and that they said they would provide for a strong presidency, and I would agree with it, you will have my resignation right away. I give you my word. If I think that I am no longer necessary, I will not stay or tarry a moment. Magkaintindihan ho sa kasayahan. I am old. I never dreamed to be the president. Well, ang ambisyon ko sa boy, small time ako. I'm just a mayor of a little city down south. I never dreamed to be a president or a higher calling more than just the mayor. Humbly, I would say, even buhay pa naman sila lahat. Ramos wanted to take me in. And IDLG, right after he won, so with Arroyo, and so with Strada. Buhay pa yan sila. Pati si Nunoy, Ochoa. On the day of his oath-taking, Ochoa and I were talking, and he was asking me if I could help. Kung makatulong ka sa amin. I sabi ko, I'm not kind of tulong. Kasi kung tatakbo ko ng presidente, wala ka naman pera, wala akong machinery. I only had 3 governors. Aimee, Governor Abbott of Garcia sa Bataan, and LAD governor sa Mindanao. Wala nga akong barangay captain isa dito. And so that was really what was playing in my mind. That even if I get too ambitious, tapos natalo, and I was worried about my city. Kasi inalagaan ko yun eh, pinalaki ko. Of course, it was very strict. And of course, I made threats. Of course, I intimidated people, mostly criminals. But it never happened to me with the other politicians in my place. It was all saliva. But yung criminal, eh, talagang, and I was made the favorite weeping boy of the human rights community. Good. You have your duty, I have mine. We were all lawyers at one time. I was also defending a client, securing to him all of his constitutional rights. But when I became mayor, I had to take care of the community. At noong na-presidente ako, I used the same threats. Yung nang himago dito sa Maynila and the cultured people, sinabi ko, putang ina kayo, pag hindi kayo umalis ng Davao, if you continue to play drugs, I will kill you. Sinabi ko sa mga kidnapper, if you do not leave Davao, by the time I take my oath of office, I will kill you pag makita kita. What's wrong with this threat? Uncultured, unstatesman. Is it wrong to threaten criminals? Give me a law which says I cannot threaten to kill bad people. And when I say, do not destroy my country because I will kill you. Do not rob us of the next generation because we need them for this republic to continue. And I will kill you. Eh kung hindi pa naman taro yan. Was in Davao and same here. And now, alam mo sa totoo lang, I'd like to host a dinner for lahat ng human rights and the bleeding hearts. I will tell them, I will commission you, I'll appoint you officially, presidential advisors, and I will raise you to the level of a cabinet member. You prepare a plan. At saka yung mga military na who do not agree with me because they think that I'm closing my ties with America. Ano kasi mga sundalo natin, most of them talagang nag-schooling yan right after in their days along the career. Pupunta ng Amerika yan kasi nag-aral yan doon. And some of them, really, well, fundamentally nothing because police work. Just my tirades against America. So if you think that you can help, sabihin mo sa akin because I will appoint you a group of presidential advisors with a cabinet position or without a portfolio but the rank of a cabinet. And I will follow your instruction to a T. Kayong ayaw sa akin, madali yan. And if the military or the police thinks that I do not, no need for a coup d'etat. God, you are wasting your bullet. Go to Malacanan, we'll have coffee, then I will myself will swear you to run this republic and solve the problem. Walang problema. The next year, there will be mass demonstration for all I care. Wala akong illusions. Do not give me a reason to go out because you might get your wish. Ano po ko presidente, ito pala. And I crossed the river at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and last night slept at went back less stressed. Araw-araw yan, ha? Kung ganun naman ang trabaho ibigay mo sa akin, I can only endure that much. Pagdating ko doon, lahat ng department, may folder yan. So, that is the work for the day. And I read it until morning time, making marginal notes, disapproving. And that is it. I do not allow yung mga pinansya na punta doon courtesy ko. You want a project, go to God eh. If you have something, go to Yasai. Kaya ako, I live in a cloistered room, which I am not really used to. And maybe just in my mind, I'd be frank, kasi it's a live telecast, that I think that I deserve a little rest. I've been a prosecutor for 10 years. I did trial work for 8 years. And then I became mayor for 23 years sa Davao. One term with Congress and another term, 4 years, being the vice mayor of my daughter. Yung may anak ako. Yung nanontok ng sirip. Yun. So, let us see, kasi meron, next year is certain financier, mayaman na babae, who married a black and is now the millionaire. And she's planning to do massive demonstration. All those who are of this Western persuasion, kung believe kayo sa Amerika, kung tingnan ninyo nakautang kayo ng loob, please join. And hindi na kailangan magkudita-kudita. Ibigay ko siya, I myself will swear you sa Malacanang. That this, and I want to do, these are the new rulers of the republic, and they will run the country. Fine. Wala mo yung problema. Karami kong kaibigan, military, pati police. Yung iba, sinakripisyo ko pa. They were my friends. But you know, I had to fire them because ako, magka-diferensya na tayo. Magkamali ka na. Except basta bayan. Hindi ka talaga papalusutin. But if somebody now, at this moment in time, sa buhay ko, I'm 72 years old. Do not ask me if I am sick. Every 72 years old in this planet is sick. But that would be a very silly question. Well, you know, sometimes you be try to say, how's your health? And one say, oh, I'm fine. Pero deep down, alam mo, bulador ka. Kung meron ako, meron ka rin. One of the greatest, maybe, just maybe, I don't know. But the greatest, sa tingin ko, that's a loss for a man to ask is, can you still make it with the lady? That is a very hurting question because with it not for the itong makers ng company ng blue pill. Kung wala na yan, wala na. Then it's time to go. Really. May pagwala na akong sabi right after the presidency. If I think or if you want to remove me, fine. Then I'll just go to the forest. Meron akong hunting lodge doon. Maraming alimatok noon yung linta. I'll just spend my days there praying. Loko naman, sa totoo lang, I do not believe in religion. I've never stopped believing in it. I believe in God. Pero yung religion, wala na yan sa akin. And I don't know if the God that I am embracing is the same as your God. Ngayon makapaniwala ako kasi no, for all of the may little belief in life at the end of my existentialism, but then of my earthly, it is really a planet which is full of agony and horror and everything. And you think, where is God? I could probably swallow a beautiful mutya being raped and ravished, but I can never accept a 1 month, 18 months, 1 year child being raped and killed. Now you know why. So those are the things sabi kong asa, which are totally unacceptable to me. As a matter of belief in life. But sometimes it can always go wrong. So I do not confess here and say that I'm the pinakamalinis ako na tao. I would be lying to my teeth. But ako, I tried my best. Itong druga. General Santiago, 3 years ago, made some projections or gave us a figure of 3 million Filipino addicts sa drugs. Sa panahon ko, when I was mayor, I was strict. And so people died. People went out of Davao and made my city safe. And that's why Davao grew and it outsmarted everybody by having a growth rate of 4, then 5, then 6. That is hard to achieve in an island full of violence and explosion. And yet we made it. And the last bloods, did it affect us? No. Because why? Because I told them it's coming. I'm in the second chapter of my speech. I'm about to end it. Basta kami, survival of the fittest. And because of my hard stand, well, if you do not want to follow the law, then follow the Bible. Kasi sabi ko, umalis kayo, huwag kayong magbinta. Sinisira ninyo ang mga anak namin. Yan ang batas. Ang batas nagsabi, bawal yan at makukulong ka. No, kung ayaw mong sundin yung batas, susunod tayo sa Bible. Anong sabi ng Bible? An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. Simply means a life for a life. Anong gusto? We have to live by certain rules. Hindi mo lang masabi iyo lang. It could not be your own philosophical theory about. Ngayon, ako ang presidente. Gusto lang tanggalin ako. Eh di tanggalin ninyo ako eh. Ay, andyan yung congressman, nakikinig sila ngayon. Go ahead, be my guest. All that I need is a statement that you removed me because I was doing my duty, period. If hindi na sabihin mo, mali ang pag-discarte mo, then how do you solve the problem? So I go back now to the set of presidential advisor. It could include the police. And how? 3 million. Panahon ni General Santiago. In my time, when I became mayor, first day, it began to squeeze everybody. Then, it was an appalling sight even for a hardened mayor like me. Na pumapatay talaga ng tao na makita ko. Hundreds of thousands surrendering, all users and pushers. Because when you are a user, you have to push. Unless you are part of the oligarchs here in this country running the show for everybody and raking all the money and profits. Nimbo mo kailangan. Pero kung ganyan bagay, you have to push, you have to connect because he will finance your monkey and this another guy will another with another victim also to take care of his monkey when the urge of Shabu is there. So, wag mo na lang yan because they are still surrendering. And now we are hitting 800 plus during my time. Wag mo na yan kasi at the end of the year, I predict it would breach the million mark. Okay? O, hayaan mo yan. Dito tayo sa 300 at 33 million. O, how do you propose? Ang sabi, eh bakit namatay yan? Yung iba, pinatay tayo. You must remember, and I'll tell you, that we are now in narco-politic country. Maraming police, general pa. And did you even realize that the early stages of my mayorship, we had nothing to do with the killing? Because they were purging and making a cleansing of the ranks. Nung pumasok kami, yung lahat ng pinatay, either murder or talagang sinalvage, o tinatalian ng plastic, and why would we do that? If you are a policeman, why would you waste your time? We are not here to produce mummies. Eh, bakit mo balutin ng plastic? Eh, di baralin mo nang sa ulo isang beses, iwanan mo. Eh, tapos pati yung mga handicraft na binabalot yung victim, naka-charge pa sa... You know, remember man, I am not declaring a police action. I am declaring war. Because ako for 23 years, I've been dealing with drugs and criminals, and I know where I come from. I have been prosecuting them in court almost every day. And when I was mayor, I was directing the operations of the police. Ngayon, ako ang may kasalanan. Look, may naman ako, kasi inspirado ako kasi matahimik kayo. Kasi minsan makikita ko nagdadaldal. Sabi ko, sige, bye-bye. Kasi... Thank you for actually giving me the privilege to talk first. I'm flying. I'm catching a flight. Ang ngayon gabi, uwi ako. 3 million. At 3 million addicts, wala pa yung 1 million ko. 200 ang going rate. So, ilan yan? 3 million, that is 6,000 a month. Times 3 million, that is 18 billion a month. Times 12, that is 216 billion a month. Money that should go to the food on the table, expenses of the children, wala na. If it's the breadwinner pagkatinamaan, then the family starts being dysfunctional. maghiwalay ang asawa, mag-away, and eventually, mag-asawa tatamaan, and then you have this horrendous and despicable crimes of rape, patay. Tamong, was it the other day? Binaril niya ang nanay niya kasi ayaw sabigan. And it has happened not only yesterday. It's happening all over the country. Bugbugin yung nanay, tatay, kasi maghingi ng pera. Ipagbili yung kung anong ma... Butit na lang, tagu-adid yung ano ninyo. Bakit wala mang adik dito? Mawala bigla yan. Kung anong mapulot yan, kaya nakawan. So, yung iba, and because the mind is warped, and somebody should tell you that using shabu for even at least 6 months on a regular basis, hindi naman sinabi na ano, that's the forensic study, on a regular basis, the brain of the person, of the user, will shrink. If it has shrunk, then rehab is no longer viable. So of the 3 million, ilan ang buang doon? Ilan ang hindi mo na mapakinabangan? Ilan yung mga anak ng mga kaibigan ninyo na wala na? Ilan yung mga anak na paying, kilala nyo na paying for 300,000 medical city, it's about 300,000-400,000 anak ng mayayaman. You try to look doon sa baba. You should try to yung old medical city. Kita mo magsiliman, naglalakad. Puro bata, puro. So, hindi pa ako mayroon. Mahinatid ako dyan, at Tagadabaw. Na mayaman, kaya niya magbayad. Sabi ng pamilya, sabi ko, sige, atid natin. Ano, ayan ang mahirap yan. Yun ang sabi, oh, bakit maraming patay? Noong una pa si Duterte, bakit walang patay? Pwede ako magmura sandali. Put ninyo. Ang pulis noon hindi nagtatrabaho. Ang pulis noon na live and let live. Oo, basta huwag mo lang kaming isali. Tawag na mga ninja. And of course, the generals. Luot. Region assigned sa Cebu. Accumulated 100 million. Sabi niya, pabili daw siya ng buy and sell siya ng bahay. Kung bahay, kung nagsabi siya na nagpapabili ako ng subdivision, maniwala ako. Magpabili ka ng bahay, maghihintay ka ng bahay, bakit pag akyat mo doon sa pinagbibilihan mo, bayad ka agad? Ngayon, bakit patay? Eh kasi nagtatrabaho ang pulis. Pero hindi lang lahat patayan. Ako ilang beses na. Ilang beses na. I tell you that hindi naman ako nag-iabang. But I was just three months old ako mayor, bakbakan. Tsaka hindi ko pinapatawad. Why? This is the time that I can kill na wala akong problema. It's all there for me to enjoy yung... Pero lumalaban talaga yan. But it would also be stupid of me to say that walang sinasalvates. But remember na kung ako civilian lang o kasi nung piskal ako, pag tinamaan yung anak ko na halos mag-utang ako sa GSIS, halos na yung mga baril ko na mga second hand na pinarepair ko, mahilig ako. Every enrollment time, sinasangla ko o pinagbibili ko. The things that I enjoyed most, I did deprive myself because of the children. Kung ako ang anak ko na rape, buhayin kita. Baski na civilian lang ako, o fiscal ako, o abogado lang ako. Anak ko, rapein mo, pati patayin mo. E putang. Yung tinatamaan, yung nagpunta sa Middle East, ang nanay sa Qatar, ang isa sa Riyadh, all working hanggang kamamatay na yun. Yung iba nga, walang tulog. Totoo yan. I'd like to say so many words about it someday. Pero parang hindi ko na mataisip. Kakatulog ng 4 oras. Kasi yung pinsan niya, hiramin yun, patrabahuin pa. Tapos yung anak pagdating, magbihis pa. So ang pobreng Pilipino matulog lang 2-3 oras tapos magising, magluto. Ano. Tapos ang ganun padala niya pera para lang makapag-aral ng anak. Tapos ganunin mo ang kanilang pagod. Sino bang Pilipino na hindi magalit yan? Kaya nasabi ko, the police can do it, go ahead. I will give you all the power. Gusto ninyo kayo magdala, military, go ahead. Gusto ninyo mag-take over, go ahead. You line up in Malacanan and I will swear you to office. Huwag tayo magbunan ito. Then solve Mindanao. Ay, kaya nga tayo nagkakaroon. Yung iba griping. Ay. Well, is it wrong to talk to the communists? Na wala ng gera ngayon, wala nang mamatay sa inyo? What did we harvest in the meantime? Makagalaw kayo. And maybe if you are not destined to die this year, then you might live for another 10 years. What is wrong to talking to Miswari and embracing him? E moro ako eh. And I want to talk to him because ang sinabi ko, Nor, we have been fighting for 40 years. Do you want another 40 years? At sinabi ko sa mga komunista, and the soldiers kayo, we have been fighting the NPAs. I was joining the left when I was young. Do you want another 45 years? Kayo! Kung yan ang gusto ninyo. Because if you do not get the federal system to work, then babalik itong, I assure you, as sure as the sun will rise in the east, babalik yung komunista, nor will go back to the mountains, and we will have a problem because this time there is the looming threat of mindless violence. Without any purpose but to kill ISIS. When? I really do not know. But are they coming? They will come. Itong ISIS ngayon, they are being edged out of the Middle East. The heaviest fighting now is in Aleppo and in Mosul. Pag nawalaan niya ng bailiwick and they do not have the mass lands, where do you think where they go? Malaysia, Brunei, Indonesia, Philippines. Where do we belong there? For lack of a better word, saan tayo dyan? Me? I will say to the Crenshaw, I'll fight you because I have more blood. And my son married a old lady who is with the Maranao mother and the Tausug father. So I'd look at my current children and say, anak, nasa inyo ako. Malalaki na. Although I tell the mayor now, si Inday and the brothers, I cannot be with you. Because I can't have to have the younger ones to protect. Ganon ang Pilipinas. Ang droga hindi nadadala ito ng tapik-tapik. You know? Tsaka ay, hindi lang ako makasalita. Eh. At kung mayroong isang tao dito na gusto ko, maybe Joelina, because I respect him and galing siya sa gobyerno di Elida. May pakita ako sa kanya. Problem? Solve? Matagal to. Pa ang promise ko sa inyo, inshallah, God willing, that promise that this campaign against drug and criminality will not stop till the end of my term. I want to see every pusher user out of the streets and all the drug lords killed. Hindi ako hinto. What do I bargain in return? O pakinggan ninyo ako mabuti. It's before the nation. Even if it cost me the presidency. Even if it cost me my life. Di talaga ako. Itong corruption na ito, it has been going on for the last so many generations. We have not lifted a finger to give the Filipino a respite kung kailan ito matapos. I will assure you, I will stop corruption during my term. Kaya nga, ano ako, 8888. Text mo lang, Department of what? Si Secretary o Undersecretary or si Yusek. Naghingi na ganito ang papel niya nandyan sa desk. Test mo yan. No need to give, if you want to give your name, okay. If not, yan automatic, lalabas yan after the news PTB4, but the government owned, it will dedicate about 30 to 1 hour. Lalabas yung mga pangalan ng mga tao na corrupt. Libel, go ahead. I don't care. If you want, file as many as you want. Ang problema, kung mahuli mo ako, may walang ibang choice dyan eh. I just fired the Deputy Commissioner for Intelligence and Investigation. And that policeman na nangungutong dyan sa mga turista, sabi niya na mga nalistahan sa drug list. Sinabi ko kay mga polis, I know how hard it is. Alam ba ninyo ang entry pay ng police even in Manila is 14,000 with the family of 2, 3, 4. That is why I promise them by the end of the year, maghanap ako ng pera, double na yung salary nila. Sabi ko muna sa ibang gobyerno, wag muna kayo. You know, because these are these guys, these are the person who would rely us to enforce public order. That everybody behaves, that dyan kayong pwesto mo, traffic dito, then they maintain order and peace. Sila yung nagpapakamatay. These are the guys na sinabi, march to Mama Sapano and die there without any question. Yes, sir. Kakaawa naman. I feel strongly for them. And, but I know that there are guys na yung of Western persuasion. But if they think that the interest of America is greater than our own, go ahead. Kasi ang Amerika ganito. You know, when I was mayor, I was already the subject of, I was the whipping boy of the human rights community. Pati na yung senadora na siya pa lang may-ari ng Cebu sa tang inyo. What if? I cannot really, but totoo yan lahat, but ako mismo hindi makapaniwala na may taong gano'n. You know, with all the pretensions na gano'n, crusading, righteous, behind us, mas mabuti pa ako, magmura ako, talaga nilalabas ko. Pero ako hindi nagsisikreto ako. Ang sikreto na sabi. Ito naman may mga ulol. May mga ulol talaga sa Pilipino eh. Sabi ito naman kung nagmumura ba ako, kasawa na. Ganon ako sa Davao. Yung taga-Davao niya, mawala sa akin. After this trip, I was still cursing. You know, I was looking at outside sky. In the plane, everybody was asleep, snoring. And somebody whispered to me, huwag kang magmura uli kasi ihulog ko yung aeroplano. Alam mo, mga buang naniwala rin. Hindi naman ako bar top notcher, hindi naman ako ganun kagago. Anak na. Kasabi ko nga, ang paborito ko sila ba magbiro ng kung ano-ano. Tapos sabi, ha? Ganun lang. Tapos babayin ko, naniwala ka pala. Kaugok mo eh. Ito, no, presidente ng Pilipinas, sabi pa itong isa, maniwala daw siya kung ako ang magkipag-usap sa Diyos. Pero kung ang Diyos na magkipag-usap sa akin, sabi niya, eskiso ka. Eh kung dalawin na kami eskiso, ang Ginoo pati ako. Kung hindi ka turpe. Tatlo na tayo, ikaw, Diyos pati... Ay nako, buhay. So, gano'n. Computation, nagawa kami ng computation sa finance, pinagawa ko sa finance. We would be spending something like 1 trillion a year para lang sa rehab, doktor, medisina. The most difficult part is detoxification. Very expensive. Wala ko tayong perang ganun. The mining industry, akala mo malaki gold dyan, gold bars, it only gives us 70 billion a year. Talo siya sa 80 billion doon sa kita ng ano. You know, this guy, they get their money from their pockets. They're supposed to support the family. Yung iba naman, kita mo wala na masyadong krimen. Kasi nagtatrabaho na ang polis. Pero ako, this is my advice to mga kababayan. Alam mo, may trabaho at tingin ko hindi pa kumpleto. Kayong lahat na suspect o alam ng namin na nandiyan ka sa mga kanto-kanto, tatambay-tambay kayo dyan, umalis kayo. Pumunta kayo sa loob ng bahay ninyo, isara mo yung pinto at upo ka sa kama o magluhod ka at kausapin mo yung Diyos. Pasya sa akin. Tapos, huwag kang lumabas. Kasi ang mga bata-bata ng Diyos nandyan sa labas. Madidisgrasya ka talaga. Madidisgrasya. Better of you yung talagang nandyan pa yung nag-ano ka na. No? It's a monkey on the back. Ika nga may unggoy na nagkakalagkad sa likod mo. Tiisin ninyo yan. There's a very low supply of drugs now. But nag-shift na naman sa kidnapping ang mga gago. So bagong laro naman to. Of the 3 weeks, we had about 6 kidnappings sa Binondo. So be careful. Give me time to talk to God and ano, di ko talaga akalain na buti pa kami sa Davao kasi simple yung utak namin. Eh, elementary school lang ako. Pero kung bulahin mo ako ng gano'n, itong katawanan lang kita. Pero kung iseryoso ko na magsulat pa ako panahon, gastusan ko pa ng panahon, bobo. Ayan ang problema. Hindi ko naman sinasabi bright ako, pero now, so that is my simple story for you. I'd like to just mingle around and say a few words, hello. Problem is, I'm trying to catch up a flight at night. So, now the only reason why I accepted this, truthfully really, is because, mga abogado, I do not accept invitations here. Kung gusto ninyo, doon na lang sa Malacañan at ako na ang mag-blow out sa inyo. Kasi ganito yan. If it is really that urgent. I know that you want to have a discourse with me. Ang problema, pag maglabas ako, traffic talaga yan. Because minutes or maybe four, sasarahan na yung kanto. And every kanto, as always, mag-exponentially, magpara ng gano'n yan. Lahat ng kampo mo sa and pag alis mo, yung, kala mo naman kung sino, ayaw ko yung gano'n. Dabaw kasi, nag-motor lang ako. Ano ba totoo? Drive ako ng taxi kasi kunwari. Kasi hindi mo malaman ang totoo pag mga security ka, gano'n. Kasi dito, iba ang security. Magtingin ko nung bago akong presidente, when I was proclaimed, kailangan pa yung mga ka-armor, gano'n. Sige ako tingin, napakahapa naman itong putang. Gano'n. Ang traffic kasi, ang tao eh. Ano ako sa tao? Magtanong ko yung tagada. Ayaw ko anuhin yung tao. Sabi ko, pinakita ako yung munga sa taas. Sabi ko, ano yan? Sabi na, sir, ambulansya. Putang. Pwede bang sabihin sa PSG na dagdagan nila ng punerarya? Para kompleto na. Pag hindi ka nila, namatay ka doon sa... ilipat ka doon sa... Anak ka ng buhay na to. Kaya ako sanay na nakukornehan ako, actually. Tinatayuan ako na... I do not want special attention. I mean, even when I was mayor, maglalakad ako dito. I would rather you do not notice my presence. Kasi ako sabi, Mayor, mahiya na kasi magtinginan niya mga tao. But this time, out of respect sa kapwa ko tao, hindi talaga ako nag-ano. If you want really to talk to me, malaki naman yung malakan yan. Pwede ba kayo kung gusto, mag-rapple tayo tuong kayo matulog para makita mo si Mr. Brown at makita mo yung, oh, may Mr. Brown dyan. Ibig si Chris Marco, si
Si Amy? Kaya ako natutulog noon sa Atbang. Tabi, at sa kabila, sa harap. Kasi yung that building there was constructed when President Clinton came here. So, isang maliit, simple lang, but the sala is very spacious. Pero may isang kwarto na maliit, siguro sa aid yun. Tapos, very simple affair. Doon, pwede rin tayo, masyadong marami dito. Nang iba, pwede ka magdala ng mga swimsuit. Malaki ang Pasig River. Pwede tayo mag-picnic-picnic doon sa riverbank. You know, really, it gets to be a very lonely life. Kaya ulitin ko, I'll close by saying that, do I appreciate your trust in me? Yes, very much. Salamat po. Are you happy now? Magbarabi. Are you happy with your work? No, I'm there to work because to survive. But it's not for that cloth there, you know. Hindi ako. Kaya tayo, Ilocano, Visaya, Samar, Moro, Maranao. Kung wala yan, hindi tayo magkakaintindihan ito. It was our forefathers who made the decision that we get together, be one as a nation Filipino. Yan ang sinasabi ko sa Moro. Huwag ninyong sirain yan because most of the Moro at the time, also signed. So, that flag is the symbol of our unity. Were it not for that flag, wala. Watak-watak na tayo. Eh, sa salita lang, pati ugali, magkaiba na yan. Sa pagmumura, iba rin. Ang ano ko is, will I survive the 6 years? I'd make a prediction, baka hindi. At one time, ang hinihintay ko lang, at yung gusto ko akong paalisin, sa about China, nothing was really, except purely economics yun. Walang alliances for, itong Amerika. Alam mo, ganito pala, bakit minumura ko ang Amerika? Ganito ho yan. Hindi ako ganun kabastos. Pero when I reach a point na parang ako pag tinatakot mo ako, takot ako. But there is a certain point in my fear na pag tingin ko parang mamamatay na ako or dihado ako masyado, inaapi-api mo ako, nagwa-wild ako. I really lose the civility in me. Ang sinabi ko, I need to fight the drug addicts. Maraming patay, totoo yan. Maraming nang gumagante, maraming naglilinis ranggo nila, yung mga grupo-grupo, at yung iba na mamatay dahil sa enkwentro ng pulis. But kayo, you are, abogado man tayo lahat, to lump it all against me as extrajudicial killing, without even a report that this guy was really murdered. And all you can show is yung what is being portrayed in the newspaper, yung mga parang duguan na tao na, life is life. Life is never fair. Well, ang buhay, hindi talaga, kung gumawa ka ng ganun, hindi ka pwede magsabi na, alam mo, nanay ko kasi puta lang eh. Tapos tatay ko, hold up here, kaya ako nakaganito. The world will never stop to listen to your story. It turns endlessly. Ikaw ang mag-adjust dito sa buhay na to where you want your place. Kaya ito sila. Ginusto nila. Tapos ang human rights dito, yellow yun eh. Noon. It was not an issue to me. You know that. I was campaigning, it was never an issue. It became only a bomb when on the last days yung sa malapit ng election, I was hitting the 36-37 rating. Wala mang kinarig niya noon sa kampanya. Sila nagbabatuhan na, corruption ako. Yeah, extrajudicial killing. Ngayon, ang Amerikano nakisali. Eh, marami yung mga social dito, mga NGO, na funded dyan sila. Itong Human Rights Watch ng New York, si kay Soros yan. Soros yung financier. The big winner. Siya yan, grant niya yan. So dito, meron na yan silang funding-funding. Maghadap talaga sila to justify. Ako, ang nakuha nila, depounding on me. Okay lang yun. Editorial, araw-araw. I can swallow that. I've been mayor, been eating newspapers as a part of my diet. Pero itong, pag itong sa Amerika, when you criticize me as mayor, okay lang. You know why? I do not represent any entity except my city. No big deal. But, yung presidente na ako, do not reprimand me or criticize me publicly. Especially if you belong to another government. Kung ikay, an NGO ko lang sa Amerika, all right yan. But for the State Department, the human rights, you can go to the United Nations, isuka mo yung anong isuka mo doon, then ask for a motion that it be referred to the Human Rights Commission, which is an entity under the United Nations, and investigate me first before you talk in public. Yan ang dapat. Hindi ko pwedeng atakihin si Obama na sabihin ko, ikaw ganun ka, ang paraan mo sa federal budget. Cannot do that. And they knew that I became a president midterm. That the budget that I'm operating now is the very same budget that was started by Aquino, which he prepared the other year, which is implemented now. Sabi na, instead of killing, bakit niya hindi lagay ng mga rehab yan? O, saan ako maghanap ng pera? I get the funding from Yasay, or get it from Dominguez, or get it from the transportation and give it to the police. That would be robbing Peter to pay Paul. Wala akong makuha. What is left now to me is MOOE, Maintenance and Operations. Wala talaga akong makuha. Ngayon, sino nagtulong? China. What did China do? Sabi ko sa military, open up spaces sa mga kampo ninyo because ang military camps, malaki talaga ang mga lupa nila. So just give me about 300 square meter, 500. Now, in Fort Magsaysay, halos tapos na. They are supposed to inaugurate it October, but I'll be going to Malaysia on a very important discussion. Importante talaga to that I have to talk to Najib. Ngayon tapos na yung good for 10,000 courtesy of the Chinese. America, anong sinabi niya? Duterte, stop the extrajudicial killing. We hold you responsible for the 3,000. Hindi muna silang isa na ipakita. The 3,000, listahan ng kill. Tapos then, if you do not stop, the assistance and funding will stop. We will stop it. Nung sinabi yung si State Department, pati nagsalita si Obama, sabi ko, you can go to hell. Let's check yung lahat. Pagtingin ninyo sa aming Pilipino, parang aso. I'm being depicted in your criticism as a dog tied to a leash. At magbigay kayo ng pan, ilalagay ninyo sa malayo. Ang Pilipino naman parang aso, hindi maabot kasi nakatali. Sabi ko, putang ina kayo. Letse ninyo. Putang ina talaga kayo. Because you violated our dignity as a Filipino people. Matter of dignity. So, Mr. Obama, what's wrong? What went wrong? Get your dictionary. Find out the right meaning of dignity. Huwag ninyo kaming ilagay na parang aso na matakot ako na mawalaan ng aid. Kaya nga sabi ko, yung mga pro-Western, if you think that America is still good for you, if you want to be a territory of America, go ahead. If it is to your personal interest, go ahead and join the demonstration. And maybe you'll be convinced me to leave the presidency. Pero I leave, at least, hindi ako nagpababoy ng Amerikano. Ayaw ko yung gano'n. Ngayon, ako lang ang nakaputang ina ninyo. Eh, kasi lang ka, ang kulang taga Mindanao eh. Kung if they are too civil about it, if they are to be prim and proper, that's your business. If you can accept those insults and keep silent, and maybe just say, well, to forgive is divine. Because foremost also I have to protect. Kung hindi lang pride, the ego of the Filipino. Kita mo sa labas, mapahiya yung mga Pilipino eh. Sabi lang, yung president, killer pa lang yan, pinatay ng tao. Without even really getting into the core of what ails this country. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much. Thank you for the enlightening message and insights of our president. The highlights of which are as follows: the concern for the survival of Mindanao. He has given us the real history of Mindanao, the actual life of being the president, including the workload, the critical problem with drugs and corruption, the challenge of being the president in the midst of criticism, and the hope for a better Philippines. Maraming salamat po, Mr. President.
So again, thank you so much, President, for that very authentic speech. Now it's time to proceed to the photo ops. Of course, joining President Rodrigo Roa Duterte, together with the National President, Governor Igot, and our GMR chapter presidents, is our first batch. We'd like to call on the National Board officers to please proceed to the right side of the stage. You are our first batch for the photo opportunity.